Get your decade ahead horoscope now at NadiyaShah.com. Hello, fabulous Aquarius. Welcome to your horoscope for the month of October 2019. Looking at life and love. I am your astrologer, Nadiya Shah. Thank you for being here. What an amazing month it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out for us right now. And as we start this month, we're still under the energy of the new moon that took place late last month. That happened in fellow air sign Libra and represented understanding your place in the world. It spoke to long distance travel, higher education, legal matters, and so much more. I spoke about it last month. And so just know that that energy is still with us in the first days of this month. It is as we navigate towards the middle of the month that the energy does change, right around the 13th, give or take a day on either side, depending on where you are on the planet, is when we will have this month's full moon. Now, this full moon is happening in a part of the sky for you that has to do with communications of all kinds. It has to do with siblings, cousins, and neighbors. And it speaks very powerfully to synchronicity, which is being in the right place at the right time, meeting the right person, and it makes all the difference. Now, it is how this full moon is communicating with other power players that makes it that much more special. We do have a beautiful connection playing out between Jupiter and this full moon. I do think that this represents a strong social energy. Chances are there'll be spontaneous moments to have fun, to connect with others as you're moving about your day. You could run into friends as well. This can also be some really good news overall where it comes to joining a group or participating in a group endeavor. And that can be enjoyable in and of itself, but it can also be big opportunities, professional opportunities. Under this energy, with that Jupiterian energy, this can also be some encouraging news where it comes to one of these types of people that I mentioned. With this part of the sky, I do want to add, because it has to do with communication of all kinds, whether that is good news, good letters, good emails, right? That's possible here. But it's also connected to media. And so if it is that you do something where you're hoping to get some media attention, you could get that right around this time. We have two other power players, Saturn and Pluto, speaking with this full moon in connections of tension. Now, both of these planets are moving through the sign just before yours, speaking with this full moon. I see this playing out a couple of different ways. One is the Freudian slip. It happens to all of us, but yes, you may have some of that where you're speaking and you don't realize necessarily what you're saying in the moment. And it is on reflection that you realize how revealing it actually was, what it is that you shared. Mostly revealing to yourself about what it is you really feel, what it is you really believe, what your truth is, can come out in those very spontaneous moments of communication. But the other part of this has to do with your own fears affecting what it is that you feel comfortable saying and what you don't feel comfortable saying. Now, where it is that you may hold back, and that can be part of your awareness as well. It is Saturn and Pluto both that are moving through a part of the sky that has to do with karma, it has to do with cleansing, and it has to do with a deeper understanding of what's happening with you underneath the surface on levels of soul and psyche and spirit. And it can be these very karmic spaces, these very unconscious places within you that can now show up in terms of what you are perceiving, what you are understanding. And as part of that, sometimes there can be misunderstandings. And so I would encourage you, you know, if it is that you have a conversation and you have mixed feelings about it, or you're left feeling kind of uncomfortable, it can be very powerful for you to connect with a friend, to share with somebody that you trust, because in so doing, in that sharing, you are ultimately going to find the wisdom that you needed to connect to it, but also to understand yourself better as you move forward beyond this full moon. As we move towards the end of the month, right around the 28th is when we will have this month's new moon. This new moon is happening at the very top of your sky. It is considered an important and sensitive part of the chart. It speaks to career, life purpose, legacy, social standing. It speaks to your understanding of your destiny. Now, new moons tend to bring new beginnings, but what makes this particular new moon distinctive is that it's standing across the sky from your modern ruling planet, Uranus. So what is happening now isn't just about what's happening with career, right? It isn't just about some new opportunity or perhaps an interview or audition or promotion situation, but it is deeply meaningful to you. It is speaking to very deep levels of what it is that you truly feel deep within you. And it speaks to your understanding of your past and where you've come from and how that informs your direction. That is where Uranus is slowly but surely moving through now, a part of the sky that has to do with home and family of origin. And where it is that seeing the past or seeing your family or even connecting with your family today helps you and motivates you to spring you forward, well, that can be part of this energy at this time. With this very visible new moon, meaning it makes you visible, it is going to be a time when chances are there may be some notice, okay? And I say this because, look, in the middle of the month, we've got all that media energy. And then we have Uranus speaking to a very visible new moon or a key new moon. And Uranus itself is a very visible energy. And so do keep that in mind with this. If it is that you like to live a very quiet life, you may be thrust into visibility very quickly. But having said that, on another level, this can be a surprise opportunity, a career-related opportunity that can feel like it's come out of nowhere, but can ultimately leap you into your future. It may be connected to someone that you've known or someone you knew way back when, contacting you now, but this is going to be part of what helps leap you in a direction of greater opportunity. Of all the signs out there, this new moon will benefit you on a career front. But Uranus is also strongly associated with authenticity and where it is that you are hoping to tap into this energy to more fully understand and fully align with life purpose for you. Well, this is where the path and those opportunities that align with your path start to feel that much more clear. For some, it's going to be an understanding of your past or your family or your roots or your ancestors that ultimately fuel this clarity as to your purpose and your destiny. And that can make this moment that much more consequential for you. But I do want to say this, just when you think you have the answer, just when you think you know which direction you're heading in, your answers might end up being something different. And I say this because at this new moon, Mercury will be standing still in the sky on Halloween Day, going retrograde. November is a big Mercury retrograde month. And of course, I'll be here to talk about it every step of the way. But here's some things to keep in mind. Yes, there may be new opportunities. That's the new moon. However, just when you think you know your direction, you may be asked to consider and reconsider or to contemplate a little bit more deeply. Just when you feel like you're excited about some new opportunity and this is what you are meant to do, you may have to ask yourself your true intentions as to pursuing a certain goal. And just when it is you feel like that goal is in reach, you may realize you need to go over old ground to make sure you like the way in which things are heading. This can be a powerful time of realignment, but that realignment very likely is going to happen as a result of the experiences that you garner in November that will allow you to see this month, October, differently. And yes, there are new opportunities and there is excitement at this time. However, it's like as soon as you feel like you are leaping forward, you will ultimately be asked to regroup in a valuable way, in a way that you will ultimately end up being grateful for. It is December when a lot of things start to come together for you. You'll understand October and November differently. You'll be able to more fully tap into the potential of this time, of this month. absolutely to your advantage. Now, I say this to you not because you should discount any opportunity that comes your way. Absolutely not. What is right for you, it will resonate. It will feel right. Your instincts will tell you this is the way to go. But what I am saying is make sure you stay connected to yourself, you're listening to yourself, and you trust the journey. That ensures that you truly are aligned with a higher, more loving vision for your life. Because when you are, there truly are that many more opportunities and big breaks set to find you. Where it comes to matters of love, it is going to be Venus that moves into this very visible part of your sky about a week into the month and will be here till the rest of the month and into the early part of next month as well. And so what this tells me is that love becomes visible. Love becomes more oriented towards the big picture and life purpose. And the purpose of your heart connections start to become a greater consideration. For those of you open to meeting someone new, energy like this does suggest that you may connect with someone who is in a position of authority or perhaps has achieved something that you admire. And it is in this attraction that it may take you a little bit by surprise, especially in the middle of the month, it may come on very quickly, but there is truly potential here. And it is in this attraction that you clarify ultimately what it is that you are really going for. For those of you who are just starting to date someone, if you're just getting to know somebody, this is going to be a time when you are thinking about whether or not this person fits into the big picture of your life and the direction in which you believe you are heading. Do they help fuel your goals and fuel your understanding of your purpose, or do they take away from that? Where it is that you feel that this new person strengthens your direction, that can solidify the bond that much more. And for those of you who are in an established bond, you know, when we have Venus moving into this part of the sky, it tends to be a time when two people together start dreaming big, start making plans, start having goals together, start thinking about the way in which they are heading and what they want to do in the bigger picture of their lives together, as is the case for you. And this can also be a time when you feel your partner's support for the goals that you have, perhaps in career, perhaps other ambitions. And you may feel that as a result of you and your partner sharing ideas back and forth, it strengthens and clarifies and raises your enthusiasm for your own goals and your pathway forward. What I love about this month for you, well, look, I'm actually going to say that full moon in the middle of the month, I know that it has challenging connections to Saturn and Pluto, and that may stir some very deep emotions that arise through your communications with others. And yet at the same time, there is so much support here. There is so much enthusiasm and positivity and love. You will know that you are not alone. You being willing to step out and engage the world in any way is going to unleash massive blessings for you now. Well, thank you so much for watching. You can get a video like this every week by logging on to NadiyaShah.com. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded exclusive video scopes each and every week, unlimited access to special horoscopes and more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. It'll be a great month. Enjoy.